Alright everyone, Scorch82, welcome back, we're playing Witcher 2. I believe that's all we have to do here, at least for the time being, so... I don't really think there's much else for us to do. I think anything else that you can find here is done on the other quest line, if you followed Yorvith. And since we didn't, let's get the fuck out! Let's go to Oblivion. We gotta go back through the fog, and that's gonna suck balls. Should probably... What the hell happened there? Should probably take this. Place of power over here. I don't remember there being one over here. Yeah, well, fuck it. Battlefield. Fog time. Finding my way back is gonna suck balls. I'm just gonna run.
Damn it.
I don't know where I'm going. Looks like I got out. That actually didn't seem nearly as bad as it was the first time I went through. What the hell's going on? Oh, crap.
Good, you're here. The Nilfgaardians attacked us.
Any idea why?
They were loitering around here, staring into the fog as if waiting for something. I summoned Fenn, Silas, and a few others, and told Vess to cover us from a distance while we went to talk to them. So I asked the black dogs courteously why they were gazing into the fog, as if the Emperor himself was about to emerge from it. No answer, but I can see the anger. Knitted brows, faces reddening. And they start growling to each other in that dog's tongue of theirs. A woman came out of the mist, beautiful and barely alive. She dropped to the ground and a small object slipped from her hand. It was a jade figurine, no larger than a man's hand. If I didn't know it was impossible, I'd say it was Triss turned into a statuette.
It is possible. Artifact compression. Where's this woman?
I don't know. The girl growled at the soldiers and all hell broke loose. The black ones jumped us and she ran off towards the camp.
I need to follow her.
We're going with you. Fall in!
Let's do this. I'm scared. Get the handle this thing first.
Is not of the human.
Damn it! This is a brothel, not a military camp.
Where the fuck is he?
And Sabrina Glevity.
Hello.
Mandrake, Seaman.
Where the fuck is the king, guy?
As such, she is an unnatural being.
Where the fuck is the king? We are in the camp. Perhaps
the
I can't do it yet,
because... men and gods.
Let's just see. It's a long text. Actually, the way through the battlefield was pretty easy this time around. Alright, well, let's find Triss.
We're too late.
Is the Percival ready to sail?
It is, but they will not let us go. Henselt has plans of his own.
I couldn't give a shit about Henselt. Shillard has Triss, and I need to save her.
It's not an option. They'll not let us sail until you lift the curse, and we've no chance of catching the Nilfgaardians on foot. If they wanted to kill her, she'd be dead already.
Besides which, we know where they've gone. Loch Muin, Witcher. The monarchs and mages are to meet and decide the fate of the known world. You will find Triss there, I promise.
He does have a point. I want to know what's in the tent. Alright, let's check this out. Song of the Hunt. No, thank you. Osterlin's first letter to the Emperor. Her Majesty, I hasten to report that Sorcerer Vanimar has indeed proven the right role. Assigned to him, he keeps his apprentice Cynthia on a short lease and displays nothing. Approaching excessive ambition. I believe him to be of unquestionable loyalty. His abilities are more than adequate to serve your Imperial Majesty's objectives. The summit will be the final test. We'll see how he behaves there, and if he proves more than capable of resisting temptation than his female colleagues did. Please convey my kindest regards to your consort, your Imperial Majesty's ever faithful servant, Shillard Fitz Osterlin. There you go. They were just camped out here, like... You'd think that there'd be a little bit more guard placed on that gate, considering it's like right there. But all right then.
King Henselt awaits you, Witcher.
Fucking time.
At last, have you got Sabrina's spear?
Not only that, I've got all three artifacts.
You won't regret it. Let's do some magic.
Uh-oh.
She died here.
And piston shat as she did.
Evil place. You can feel it in the air. Those candles don't help any either.
They've gone mad. Someone said the bitch died a martyr, and now the common folk burn candles for her.
I have to observe this place from a distance.
During the execution, I was on that hill. I'll show you.
All right, so get to it. Walk faster.
Thank you.
Hello. Alright, so guide Hansel as he draws the magic runes illustrated in Deathmold's grimoire.
Flat area. That's good.
Are you concerned for your feet?
Your Majesty, you need to draw runic protective signs around the stake.
Magic signs are the domain of witches, not kings. Correct me if I'm wrong.
So with the curse, you have to draw a circle.
It's important that you draw the circle yourself, Your Majesty.
Important for whom?
It was your death Sabrina foretold, so who do you think?
All right. Tell me what we do.
To lift the curse, we have to reenact the events from 3 years ago.
How do you wish to do that if half of those involved lie rotten with the worms?
It's about the energy of that time. The energy of the woman who cast the curse, combined with the energy of its victim. When you get the runic signs right, Sabrina's ghost will appear.
Bring the bitch to life. It'll be a pleasure to put my spear in her.
Remember to stab her in exactly the same spot as that soldier did, but earlier this time, before the sorceress completes the curse.
I look for the hole. But how am I to know when?
When you realize that the curse concerns you. But be ready, she may use a different name.
Is that all?
For you. Then I take over. Spectres might appear during the exorcism.
Might or will?
It depends on Sabrina's aura in the spirit world.
I'll wager ghosts loathe the cunt. Let's get it over with. Tell me what I am to draw.
You have to go down there, Your Majesty.
What about you?
I'll guide you. I have a good view from up here.
I need to look at it and see. Let's see. So I'm gonna have to draw that just so I can make sure, and then I'll tell him where to go. I'm drawing it on a piece of paper so I can be sure. And then down to the bottom, and then up top, and then back to where he started. It's a cow's head. What's this up here? Gult skull, raven's corpse, sour milk. Is that the petrified bread? Yeah, that's what that is.
Go towards the pixie ring, Your Majesty. I must have got it wrong, sire. We need to start again. Pour the powder towards the petrified bread loaf, Your Majesty.
Alright, so there's one line. Now, the mushrooms, or whatever those stupid things are.
Head towards the black candles, Your Majesty.
Stuff in this in the end, is that the No, that's not it. do believe that's the one I want him to go to.
Now go towards the goat skull, Your Majesty.
There we go. This is crazy. Now, the Raven's corpse. No, that's not it. Scorched tree, that's the one.
Now towards the burnt tree.
He's dropping white powder. Okay. And now... sour milk? Nope. Raven's corpse.
Find the Raven's corpse, Your Majesty.
And now the sour milk, Your Majesty, and then the pixie ring, and then you're done.
Now spread the powder and head for the stone bowl. Go towards the pixie ring, Your Majesty.
There it is.
Sire, form a large, even circle at a good distance from the pyre.
It's turned out beautifully. Pity the wind will soon scatter it.
The evil power of the curse came from the fire. Fire's a hard element to tame, and this one had added potency. It consumed the body of the one casting the curse.
Enough of these phantasmagorias, as Deathmold puts it. Look at my boots!
Stay in the circle, Your Majesty.
The powder reeks of dwarven dung.
Light the magic powder with the Igni sign. I have to do it from up there, or can I do it from down here? Damn it. You blow. Now that'll do.
They're scared of ghosts, as we all are. Curses! There's hundreds of them!
Calm down, Your Majesty. We're protected by the magic runes. The ghosts won't get past the barrier.
I'm not afraid of people, but those plowing creatures have begun to bother me.
You're safe if you stay within the runes.
What should I do?
When the sorceress calls your name, you have to show mercy and end her suffering with the spear. You've broken the circle. Spectres could get through.
What shall we do?
I'll take care of them. You finish the exorcism, Your Majesty.
Curse you, Henselt! By blood and fire! Let it be so by blood and fire!
You better finish!
Split the heavens and follow this mortal journey with a trail of blood! Be duped by the sight of fish scales turned by magic into square pieces of gold. Let the unicorn dance into thousand-year-old bones. Dark fire devouring air. By the charred bones of the innocent. Let the prophecy be fulfilled.
Shame I can't really concentrate on what's being said.
In accordance with my prophecy, you cannot escape your fate. Curse you, Henselt! By blood and fire! Let it be so by blood and fire!
Now, Your Majesty!
Yeah!
it worked.
Are you sure?
All I can say for sure is that a dwarf can pass between a troll's legs, even on tiptoe. And I think it went well.
Good. For me and for you. But all the worse for Edirne.
I've separated you from the curse, but it remains active and powerful. The specters of the Fallen continue to fight in the fields outside Vergen.
You'll find a way, like you did with that charcoal slot.
That'll be much harder.
I have faith in you, and faith can move mountains.
Funny you say that. I need an artifact symbolizing faith.
Yes, Deathmold told me. I'll give you the medallion. First, I must have a drink. Come to my tent. I'll roll out my best wine. You deserve it!
Can we have beer instead? Yeah, I was kind of hoping that I could actually concentrate on what was actually happening rather than fighting with the fucking specters, but whatever. 2 talents. Yay. What do I want? Vitality plus 50. Critical effects through signs. Yurden traps join together, preventing foes from moving between glyphs. I like that. I can mutate. Alright, now we can finally use some of the crap that we've found here. Damage 1 to 2, greater power, greater critical effects, range mutagen, vitality plus 10, strength, armor plus 2, I like this. We have one more, so let's do vitality plus 50. Oh man, I rule. Go to his tent. Running into the bushes here. What the hell am I doing? Oh my god. Uh-oh, there's a crowd here. And they're fighting still.
Whoever comes and tells him, the elder and the recruiter are coming for you.
Alright, I gotta cross here. Fucking shit.
Can be really sick.
I've been impressed so far with the quest interaction. It's been fairly fresh. Not the same old repeatable crap. And it's linear, but it's not linear, you know? It's like it's not too easy to figure out what to do, but some of the things are a little cryptic. You know, so it's got some work, but I'm fairly impressed so far.
A rebel and troublemaker is not of the human kind.
Not right.
The king is occupied. Return after sundown.
No, I can see him. He's got his fucking hat off and everything.
I've no bloody idea who you might be, but I hope you're a civilian.
You know what? You've seen me come and go so many times that I don't even know what the hell's wrong with you. You son of a bitch. It's already freaking sundown. Damn it. Alright, let's go.
The king is occupied. Return after sundown.
I did! God darn it. I already meditated and did all that time. Alright, the sun's down. Let me in. Ass face.
Get a hold of yourself, soldier.
I'm glad you're here. A messenger from Redania arrived this morning. Read.
The king of Redania, Radovid V, son of Vizima and Hedvig from Malior, the heir...
Get to the point.
The point is, it's not true that after the death of King Foltest, Temeria will be inherited. In truth, Foltest left a lawful heir.
Who is this heir?
Due to the tragic death of Prince Busi, his sister Anaïs will inherit the Temerian crown.
Witcher, you fought in the battles for the Lavalette's fortress. Tell me, how old is this princess?
She's only a child.
She's too young to rule.
Remind me, who's her mother?
Anaïs's bastard offspring.
That's it. Bastards cannot be heirs. If you counted all the bastards I begat, I could fill all the thrones of the North. What the hell's going on? Guards!
The hell is going on? Fight! Get out! Make sure that's what I'm actually carrying. Death.
Who are they?
They wanted to kill me. Me! Ha! The scum. Witcher, we must talk. Deathmold said you needed this medallion. You saved my life, and I'm not nearly as ungrateful as some might say. You'll receive the pendant in due time.
Pity none can be taken alive.
Don't fret, Tanzaville. There are ways to make a dead man speak.
I know those methods. Necromancy is forbidden.
In the absence of the Council and the Conclave, it's hard to know what is forbidden.
What would you say, Your Majesty?
I want to know everything. Plow that corpse if you have to. Do anything it takes.
Necromancy, Your Majesty, is a branch of magic.
I don't care. Do as you're told.
Count me out.
As the common folk say, be at ease, the woman's gone. I'll need your help, Witcher. You know where to find me.
It's never ending. I'm the bloody king, but she mumps and sulks like some common servant was trying to grope her.
Burn her at the stake.
Not every sorcerer is like Deathmold. Many don't like messing with corpses.
As long as she's in my camp, she'll do as I say. Go. Deathmold is probably biting his nails in anticipation.
King is kind of a douche. I don't really want to help him, actually. But... Whatevs. I'm trying to remember what else is here. Wait for events to unfold. Well, there's not really anything happening. Alright. Well, let's do it. A bunch of these quests are all tied together. One thing I don't really care for is the fact that a lot of these quests that they give you, they're all related. So it's hard to tell, like, what's unique and what's not. Hey, what's going on, guy?
Geralt of Rivia, ready for the ride of your life?
No.
Can't handle this without me?
You're a mutant, like this killer. An ordinary man would never survive Han Marvin's blue dream. You must drink a potion that will increase your heart's efficiency and strengthen your blood vessels. Hallucinogenic properties are also welcome, as they will enhance the vision.
Gadwall should do it.
How does it work?
Necromancy's awfully fishy. What do you aim to do?
Han Marvin's Blue Dream is a spell that grants you a glimpse of a dead man's memories. You'll see, feel, and taste what the killer experienced in his life. As a mutant, the operation isn't at all dangerous for you.
Alright, let's do it.
You look your normal self. Have you had your fill of fortifying potions? It would be foolish if you died due to a simple oversight.
Not just yet. I need to prepare. Gadwall should do it.
Alright. Well, do I have Gadwall? Do I have a diagram for Gadwall? Doesn't look like it. Alright, I'm gonna have to go buy it. Let's trade. Formula, Gadwall. Damage minus 40%. I don't really want that. Alright. Alchemy. Gadwall. Alright. Vigor regeneration. Let's see. I wonder if I could cancel the effects out. Damage plus 10, toxicity 25. Toxicity's pretty high. Make sure I'm not running around drunk. Oh man. I'm so like